We all know secrets management is important, including in your containerized solutions. Yoko is here to show us how we can use HashiCorp Vault with Azure Kubernetes Service to store and retrieve secrets easily, today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. Today we're going to learn about using HashiCorp Vault inside of Azure Kubernetes Service. So we talked about it earlier about using HashiCorp Vault for secrets management, but now we're going to be talking about it in a more containerized scenario, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And containerization has been pretty common practice nowadays.
Yeah, it's huge. It's very popular.
Yeah. And Kubernetes is a popular orchestration tool.
Pretty much one war, yeah.
And the next questions people start asking is where to put the secrets.
Okay.
Like if your container needs to talk to external database, then where are you going to put the database credentials?
Right.
HashiCorp Vault is an open source secret management tool, so it can be a good solution for that.
Got it.
And then our users recently started asking more and more, can we use HashiCorp Vault with Kubernetes?
Okay.
And that's the questions we are getting a lot. Right. The answer is yes, absolutely.
Perfect.
To help that, so HashiCorp Vault use client server model. Mm-hmm. So that means the container that needs to talk to Vault to retrieve secrets, that client has to first authenticate with the Vault server.
Got it.
Basically, make sure that it's a valid client.
So what I would do is a Kubernetes, if I'm running a Kubernetes cluster, whatever that service account, I would then go over to HashiCorp Vault and basically give that permissions.
Yes.
Right? And then what you're going to show me now is what the communication looks like between that service account inside of a Kubernetes cluster talking to HashiCorp Vault.
Yes, exactly. So here, for that, the clients can be Kubernetes, but also can be any applications or can be user.
Sure.
And we do have a number of authentication methods that we support, and Kubernetes is one of them.
Okay.
So as you mentioned, Kubernetes using the service account, we can validate that container's identity.
Okay.
So to demonstrate this, to save some time, I've already have Kubernetes authentication method configured.
Okay.
So this Vault server that's actually running on the Azure VM already knows about the service account.
Got it.
And I have a Kubernetes clusters running on AKS.
Got it.
Already. And I love it how you can just copy the commands to launch the dashboard. It's so nice.
Yes.
So I already have a Kubernetes dashboard running.
Okay.
To just demonstrate, I have a simply have a Linux container running and Alpine image. Nothing particular.
Got
just
it.
Simple.
So we
container.
Actually have, it sounds like we have a several machines here. We have a inside of our Kubernetes cluster, we have an Alpine image just sitting there, right? And that's what we're going to use to show how we can actually connect
yes,
to the Vault. The Vault is actually running in a Linux machine, also running in Azure, but not inside my cluster.
Exactly.
All right, good.
Perfect. Yes. Because this is just a plain Linux container. It doesn't know anything about Vault.
Okay.
So I'm going to just use curl to make the direct REST API invocation against the Vault server. So I've already done this. And also, I already put the Vault server's location as an environment variable, so I don't have to type it up.
Sure.
And similarly, I also have that Kubernetes tokens store as an environment variable as well. So this is a container. This is the identity of the container.
Got it.
So now I'm going to do the authentication. So this command, this is the API call. This container is doing invoking login endpoints against the Vault server's API using Kubernetes authentication method that I've already configured.
Okay.
And passing Kubernetes token as an input in a payload. And also here, I say example. This is basically the same example role.
Okay.
This is the same, very similar to IAM role in Azure. So that dictates how much of a secret this particular client can read or store.
Okay, he's requesting access to the example role.
Yeah.
Right, and this is who I am, and please go log me in.
Yes.
Got it.
Yes.
Okay.
So as a matter of fact, the Kubernetes token was valid service account, so it returned, Vault server returned the client token.
Okay.
And here you can see the role is set to example, and here it has token policies. In Vault server, we use policies to control the access of the clients.
So this is what permissions it has to do.
Exactly. Okay. So this policy only gives read and list permissions against this particular endpoint.
Got it. So you can't add any new secrets. You couldn't delete them, but you can read and list them to see what secrets are in there.
Okay. So basically, whatever that this container, I determine this is all this container has to be able to do.
Perfect.
It shouldn't be able to do anything else more than that. So I'm going to show that I'm not lying.
This is a real demo.
Yes. So every request, you have to pass the valid token
that you received when
in
you authenticated
the header.
Got it. Okay.
And then I've already have Vault address as an environment variable. Mm-hmm. So. And I have just put in posh JQ for pretty output. So voila. So this is the secret that this container was able to read.
Right.
And to verify that I'm not lying to you, I have some secrets already pre-populated.
Gotcha.
So password, username, app user. So this is exactly the same as this container was able to read from the Vault server.
Perfect. So if I needed a connection string or whatever my application needed, I would be able to use these commands to authenticate.
Right.
Perfect.
So to make sure, so let's say I try to read secrets from somewhere I don't have access to, and it will say permission denied.
Perfect.
Because the Vault server's policy dictates access. So this sounds like pretty reasonable solution for our Kubernetes users. But then what if you have dozens of containers running in a pod? Mm-hmm. So does that mean do I have to do the same thing, authentication from every single container? That sounds like a lot of kind of similar repeated process. To solve that, we also have what we call Vault agent, which is same thing as a Vault server's binary, same binary that you download from Vault project website.
Okay.
Instead of running it as Vault server, run it as an agent mode.
Okay.
What it does is, again, so you are just running, Vault agent runs on the client side instead of server side. So it does the authentication and acquire client token and put that token into sync. Sync is a location where agents will put that secrets to, I mean, the token.
Okay.
Inside. Then other containers within the same pod, instead of going to the Vault to authenticate, just use that already acquired token to use that and put it in the header and make that API request against the Vault server.
I see. So you're caching your credentials essentially on the got it. And then any of the images in that pod or containers running in that pod will then be able to authenticate against it without having to re-authenticate the
service. Right, exactly.
Okay,
and Vault agent will manage that.
Got it.
And so I'm not going to have enough time to demonstrate that, but if you want to give it a try, it's nothing but just running in the, we actually do have an official Docker image for Vault.
Okay.
So if you want to give it a try, run it on your pod, just use that Vault image, the latest image, to try it and run it in an agent mode. We do have a Learn website.
Okay.
And I actually have a Vault agent with Kubernetes demo.
Okay.
And this gives step-by-step instructions to do exactly what I just mentioned about what if you have a multiple containers within a pod.
Got it. So this will help you authenticate against all that as well. Now, I've seen you calling out straight REST API calls. So obviously, any language who can make a REST API call, which is almost all of them, could make those same calls. But are there client-side APIs or clients that I could use if I'm already a .NET developer or VB or Ruby or something? Looks like there are. Great.
Yes.
So those libraries are going to allow me to, they're going to obfuscate and encapsulate all that REST API communication, and I just use their API to make the same call.
Yes. Okay, perfect. If you have a special language.
Yes. And so we have Ruby, we have Go, and I think we also had some other
community
ones too.
C-sharp
and .vb.net.
Yeah.
Awesome. Cool. Well, this is great. So now we can make sure that our container secrets are just as easy to manage as our secrets from anywhere else by being able to authenticate the service account for a Kubernetes cluster inside of HashiCorp Vault.
Yes.
Perfect. Thank you so much. So we're learning all about using HashiCorp Vault inside of our containers here on Azure Friday.